Usually gardens and other golf courses, as well as lawns, as well as fields in universities and institutions, generate a lot of litter. And even after lawn mowings and trimmings of the grass, we get so much of green matter. Usually this green matter is being carried away and thrown into dumping grounds, or is burnt, which through which we lose a lot of resources. These resources can be recycled and can be brought into useful manure, which can go back into the soils to make the soils productive. Especially when the soils require a lot of moisture, these organic matter can hold back a lot of moisture. What do I require for this? There are several ways of composting. There are aerobic composting, anaerobic composting, and there are several other mechanisms. Here we find a simple model which we call it as biodung composting. In this composting process, we set up this sort of a unit at the base with some bricks and some sticks over that, or twigs, whatever you have with you. The main purpose of setting up this unit is that it allows aeration from the base so that the air can come in through this and flow through the composting pile, whereby we do not use any renewable energy for this particular purpose of aeration. Now here, what the materials required are just this sort of twigs and sticks, a few bricks or stones on which we can lay these sticks, a huge pile of organic matter which you find over there, the grass litter, the grass mowings, the lawn mowings, as well as some litter from the compound. We require a little bit of dung. This is very important for us. You see, any composting process can take place only if there are microorganisms in it. You can buy microorganisms from the market, but you don't require anything. In case you have cattle dung with you, cattle dung is a very good source of microorganisms. So what these students are doing here is mixing cattle dung in water. Normally, when microorganisms are mixed up with water, they multiply faster and they require moisture for that purpose. So this will be the inoculum. So let us first start with the first layer of putting up the matter. Preferably, we use carbon-rich material at the base. What is carbon-rich material? Dried leaf litter is carbon-rich. So we use dried leaf litter first, the broad-based leaf litter, which forms the basic structure of the base. So shall we start with the dried litter, please? Come. Come over, please. Come over, come over. Yeah. Now, this is a source, this is a source of dry litter, which you can put. In fact, if you have broad-based leaves or newspapers, you can put them on the top. These broad-based leaves can hold them further. So, if in case you have them, you can use them. Otherwise, you just put them. When you are setting up the pile, please see to it that you remove these sort of plastics and other foils which may accidentally come in the litter. So, please remove them, and you find that this pile, you put it to a height of about 9 to 10 inches. Now, this is what they had diluted. Now, this diluted cow dung, you just sprinkle it over top. Either you can do it like this, or if you want to be more clear, you can do it. Many of our Asian countries and African countries have a lot of such organic matter, and they have rich biodiversity of organic matter. So when this biodiversity goes in, the quality of the manure also improves a lot. Now this layer is followed by green. Yeah, it's over there, Ashwin. This is called as a heap or a pile. The same thing, if it is extended beyond 10 feet or so, it's called as a windrow. It's called as a windrow. It is warm because biomass, please remember that biomass, when you keep them together, generates a lot of heat. To set up a pile, please remember that the dimensions minimum is about 4 feet by 4 feet to a height of about 4 feet. Why should we have a minimum? Because that encourages generation of lots of heat in it. If anything less than that, then it will not generate much heat. Now, some of you may say that we don't have access to cow dung. We have goats with us. Can we use goat dung? Yes, you can also use goat dung soaked in water. No, we don't have any animals with us. But still, we would like to do this. In such a situation, please buy yogurt. preferably curd is better if you form it at home, because curd has more microorganisms than yogurt. But if you don't have curd, then use yogurt. Allow it to sour for about 3-4 days. Don't buy it straight from the supermarket and use it immediately. You allow it to go sour. Once it is sour, it has a lot of microorganisms in it. You can mix this in water, little bit of water, and again, that can be used as an inoculum because this has lactobacilli in it, microorganisms. Whereas when you use curd, the importance of curd is it has streptococcus as well as lactobacilli, which means composting is faster. Box of yogurt. We have taken water. In this you can add a little bit of yogurt. And this yogurt mixed up, diluted, can also be used as an inoculum. If you are working in a kampong or a village, you don't have access to yogurt or cow dung, then any vegetable you have, for example, especially banana, papaya, pumpkin, these type of vegetables, you chop them up, add little bit of brown sugar into it, allow it to ferment for about 10 or 15 days. It will give a beautiful fermented odor. Use this fermented liquid as an inoculum. It is the main purpose of me presenting this to you is that to make you understand that you don't have to depend on any external source to do composting. Whatever is generated from the kampong or from your institution or from the university or from any place can be used for composting. Summer water, please. Yeah, that's it. Very good. Yeah. Sprinkle some more liquids. It holds in position. Yeah. And one final layer of dry material and we stop it.
You want some more? Bro?
Some more dry material. Yeah, that liquids, yes. Liquids, yes. Use the nozzle. Yeah. Now, as they do this, I would like to tell that you have been noticing that we have been sandwiching alternate layers of dry litter along with green litter. The advantage is that the green litter can produce a lot of heat in it because it has too much of energy. And the brown is carbon source. The main purpose is if the carbon source goes down, then the nitrogen can increase. And when nitrogen increases, it becomes a gas like ammonia. And the importance of the manure will be lost because ammonia will get evaporated. The carbon is able to satiate the needs of nitrogen. So a carbon-nitrogen balance is always essential when you set up a composting unit. You may ask, how much should we put carbon is to nitrogen? Normally till 30, C is to N ratio to the ratio of about 30 can be used. In the case of garden litter, in the case of kitchen waste, they are naturally balanced. Nature has balanced them already for the composting purpose. But if you are handling industrial waste, which is rich in lignin, then you will have to balance the carbon-nitrogen ratio. Here is the entire unit. You find this unit to be so tall and about 3.5 to 4 feet high. This unit will start generating heat right from the second and third day. It is desirable if you have a good remote probe type of a thermometer, you can check the temperature. But never resort to using a mercury thermometer, because if a mercury thermometer breaks inside, you will be contaminating the manure with mercury. So be careful that you don't use it. Well, your question now is, I don't have a thermometer, but I should know. Yes, you can. So on the second or the third day, take a stick like this and just insert it in the middle. That way. Leave it for about 10 to 15 minutes and then remove the stick and feel it here. It should be warm. If it is warm, your unit is fine. If it is not warm, there is something wrong with your unit. These simple tests are essential and will be good monitoring for schools and social programs to understand the concept of temperature increase. Why do I need a temperature increase? I need a temperature increase because when I prepare a manure, there should be no pathogens in it. So at high temperatures of about 60 degrees Celsius, pathogens will be destroyed. I don't need seeds of any weeds in it. The seeds will be destroyed. And we have a properly baked compost which will be ready. In Asian countries and African countries, the weather is totally unpredictable nowadays. So there's a possibility that there may be rainfall or there may be excess heat, in which case it will get dried up or totally wet. Now this polythene, now watch how we do it. We'll just cover it, not fully. There is a space here so that the air can go in. During the day, when it is hot, the water inside will start evaporating. This evaporating water has no place to go. So it will go and stick on the inner side of the polythene. In the night, when it goes cool, the same water condenses and comes back into the pile. By this regular movement of water, microorganisms also move. And that helps composting being faster, and that helps the temperature increase within the third day. Temperature will increase till the temperature goes to a height of to a maximum of about between 55 and 65 degrees Celsius. After that, it starts coming down, maybe around the 12th day or the 15th day. So as it comes down, you will find that the pile has also come down. Now, you had just seen how the composting unit was set over there. Now, after 15 days, you find that the compost unit has come down. This happens because of the proper processing of composting. The temperature has come down and now it is ready for turning over. Turning over is a must, because in any composting pile, the temperature that builds up takes care of all the matter which is in the middle, but not on the periphery or on the outside. So when we turn over, we do it in such a way that the outer leaves go in and the inner composted matter comes out. You'll just watch how we are going to do it, that process. At the same time, we can add a little bit of liquid if it is dry. So we may require a little bit of cow dung and water, or at least plain water or yogurt and water for this process as well, which is around 12th or 15th day of setting up of the unit. Look at the beauty of which the compost is getting formed. So that much of pile, that's the reason I said. And please remember one thing, there may be several types of leaves. Now this is a very thick variety, so maybe this will take longer to compost. Don't get worried about it. Whereas some will get totally composted, as you see over here. Some are getting totally composted, which have changed completely. So now we'll start turning over. We'll remove portion of this and keep it out. The pile is still a bit warm. What you find here is the fungus. All these help in the composting process. It has been going through a very beautiful composting process. You can smell, it's beautiful. Why we call the type of biomass we had used? The biomass we have used is almost looking like a dung here. So the biomass gets converted something like cow dung. Look at the way it is, like cow dung. So this is now doing beautifully. One turnover and another about 2 weeks time, you will get lovely manure which can nourish your soils and the plants. One thing we must remember is, in chemical farming, we feed the plants. In organic farming, for which we use this manure, we feed the soil. The soil feeds the plants. Now again, keep it covered with the polythene. The temperature will rise again, because now we have mixed it over. The temperature will rise again, and in another 15 to 20 days, you find wonderful crumbly material available, which could be used for your own lawns and gardens. This turnover which you do is sufficient. After another 15 days, that is totally 30 days, the compost should be ready. In case you have used very thick leaves with higher organic content in it, maybe it will take one more turnover, otherwise it is not necessary. For lawn waste and other waste, only one turnover is required. After that, the manure is ready. How do I use this manure? Take the manure, air dry it, and then start using. One simple test I would like to tell you. In case you are going to apply the manure and you want to know whether the manure is really ready or not, take a little bit of that sample. put it in a polythene bag, ordinary carry bag, wrap it up, leave it for 24 hours. After 24 hours, put your hand inside it. If it is warm, that means the composting process is not yet over. If it is cold or normal temperature, that means compost is ready, you can use it. Because what will happen otherwise is, if you use raw material and put it too much in a plant for composting, then what will happen is the tender roots will be burnt and the plant may not grow. So we have to be careful when we use compost. And compost also, you must use only in reasonable quantity, maximum 1 to 10 kgs for a big tree and about a handful for a potted plant. Don't think that it is compost and you can add any amount you want. You will burn your plant. Be careful. Thank you.